this actually started anchoring, started somewhere in US, and that's where they discovered investor psychology. There was this white goods merchant, he had kept a $25 mixie on a shelf, a new unknown brand, and it was there on the shelf, $25. It wasn't selling. It wasn't selling at all. So anyway, he's bought, so he's chal raha hai, kaam chal raha hai. Then suddenly, he notices, you know, that in between that, what happens? One of those shelf sales assistant, there was a mixie there, $25 mixie, takes a $100 food processor, which includes mixie, grinder, whatever, or juicer and all, and keeps it next to that. Just while cleaning, just for the sake of all that. And he suddenly saw that sales started going up of $25 mixie, which was not moving, to such an extent that the $25 mixie was sold out. So the owner was like, yaar, kya ho gaya? How come suddenly this mixie has become hot, hot cake? He goes to the shop floor, and when he goes to the shop floor, he sees, arre, $25 mixie, $100 blender, mixie, juicer, whatever. And then he realizes there is some connection between this happening, and that is called anchoring effect. By anchoring effect, what happens is, in the psychology of the investor or the psychology of the consumer, what did you put first? First was 25, but when a new customer went, he saw 100, and next 200 he saw 25. Now does 25 look cheap or costly compared to 100? Cheap. So what happens? You buy it. Same thing investors do. Same thing investors do. Investors, if you tell them buy ACC, 1600. Word of it. Prism cement, 16. You understand? They want cheap. They don't understand whether it's stock split or whether it's worth zero. But they want cheap. They're not understanding that if you buy a costlier stock, it's a better stock, etc., etc., fundamental. So this is what we call anchoring, because you get anchored in the brain. There is a beautiful Italian cafe which is there in Venice. And you know what they have done there? You know, Venice, Italy is the place for Vespa scooters. All of you know. So there's a Vespa cafe. And in that Vespa cafe, what they've done, the best Vespa, latest model, is on display in the cafe with all spotlights, rotating and all that. And when you go inside, you sit down, you open the menu. What do you see? Buy the latest Vespa, whatever, 900 euros. Ticket, write it from here. And below that, latte, 30 euros. You know, cappuccino, 25 euros. Italian espresso, 15 euros. Don't you think, when you think of all these, 15 euros is nothing? 900 euros you are seeing. I have anchored 900 in your brain, and I am giving you at 15 euro. That coffee is not worth 3 euro. But your brain tells you, parvaila pa, only 15 euro. Let's have one coffee at home. Did you get how anchoring works? And this is how stock market also, we do have that feeling of anchoring when it comes in. Here you'll see typical marketing. Now this was old marketing. Get lots of data, better than street price, $49. Bad marketing. Good marketing, get 10,000 MB. See, big figure. Retail price, $99 for 49. How does it sound? Can you get the way how investors' mind works? And you'll all do that. Buy one, get one free. 33% off. All these are nothing but anchoring big price. Okay. All of you all have seen all the TV ads, Giriyas, Yeo and all. Have you seen something which I want you all to notice? They give two prices. Have you noticed? Give one price. Give the lowest price. Why you want to give the highest price? For anchoring. Did you get the investor psychology, how it works? They show you 67-inch LED TV, 8,49,000, now struck down to 4,69,000 or whatever. So I give you, same thing happens when a stock price goes up 80 rupees, and now the company is gone bankrupt. But because you bought at 80, when it comes to 40, you feel it is cheap. It's very cheap, no? So you buy more. Now 40 ka 20 available. More cheap. How can you not buy? So that's how investors get anchored over the first price and they keep on buying lower sometimes, and that's anchoring.